Hello students, in today's video we shall be discussing about voice and its kinds. So before discussing about the topic in details, let us see few examples. Example 1. Rhea writes a letter. Example 2. A letter is written by Rhea. In the first example, that is Rhea writes a letter, Rhea does the action. That is, Rhea is the doer of the action, writes. So, Rhea, that is the subject, has been shown to be active. Again, in the second example, that is, a letter is written by Rhea. Here, the subject, a letter, is acted upon. And it is the receiver of the action, is written. That is, the subject is not active but passive. We must note that the two examples here expresses the same meaning, but the form is different. So, it can be said that voice is the change of form in verb to show whether the subject is the doer or the receiver of the action. As you have seen in these two examples, Rhea is the doer of the action and letter is the receiver of the action. Now, there are two kinds of voice. They are active voice and passive voice. Here, the first example, Rhea writes a letter. Rhea is the subject who is doing the action directly of writing a letter. So, when the subject of the verb does something itself in a given sentence, the verb is said to be in the active voice. In the second example, a letter is written by Rhea. The subject here is a letter, but the work of writing is done by another. In other words, in this example, the subject and the doer are different. Here the work of the verb is not done by the subject. So, when the subject of the verb does not act itself but is acted upon, then the verb is said to be in the passive voice. So, now let us see the definition of active and passive voice. So, when the subject of the sentence is the doer of the action, then the verb is said to be in active voice. But when the subject of the sentence is the receiver, that is acted upon, then the verb is said to be in passive voice. There are some rules that we need to follow while changing a sentence from active to passive voice. So they are: the passive voice is formed by using appropriate forms of the verb be with the third form of the main verb, which means that the verb be has three forms in present tense, that is am, is, are. Two forms in past tense, that is was, were, and its third form is been, along with the third form of verb, that is the past participle of the main verb. This is how the passive voice is formed. Then, number two, the object takes place of the subject. So, in passive voice, the object becomes the subject. Number 3. The subject is either left out or mentioned at the end as a mere agent of the action done. So, it means that more emphasis or importance is given on the object of the verb rather than the subject, which remains passive or inactive in the passive voice. The next rule is, the verb does not change its tense but its form only. It means that if the verb or action in a sentence is in present tense, then while changing it into passive voice, the verb will remain in present tense only but not past or future tense. Similarly goes with past and future tense as well. Another rule that we have to keep in mind while changing sentence into passive voice is that the preposition, that is by, by, is mostly used to show the subject as an agent or doer of action. Sometimes other prepositions like to, with, at, in, etc. are used in place of by. So in passive voice, the preposition by is mainly used in order to show the subject as the doer of the action. Other prepositions like to, with, at, etc. are also used sometimes in the place of by. But there is an important thing that we have to keep in mind regarding the changing of active voice into passive voice is that there is no passive voice of the verbs used in future continuous tense, and the three perfect continuous forms of all the three tenses, that is past, present and future. So only 8 forms of verbs can be changed out of the 12 forms. They are simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense. Then simple past tense, past continuous tense and past perfect tense. On the other hand, in future tense, only 2 forms of verb can be changed into passive voice. They are simple future tense and future perfect tense. So these are the 8 forms of verb in which we can make or where we can change active voice into passive voice. So these are some of the general rules that we have to keep in mind while changing an active voice into passive voice. But in this video, we are going to learn and discuss how to change the forms of verbs from active to passive with reference to all the 3 forms of present tense. So let us first see some examples in order to understand this concept in a better way. Simple present or present indefinite tense. So here 2 columns are given. So in one column there is examples or sentences which are in active voice. In the second column we notice that there are also some sentences or similar sentences, but they are in passive voice. And also all these sentences are in simple present or present indefinite tense. Example 1, I read a poem. So this sentence is in simple present or present indefinite tense, but it is in active voice. And when we want to change it into passive voice, it will become a poem is read by me. Then example 2, she plucks flowers. In passive voice, it will become flowers are plucked by her. Number 3, Ram plays on a flute. When we want to change it into passive voice, the object, that is a flute, will come before. So it will become the subject here in the passive voice. So it will become a flute is played on by Ram. Number 4, you do not like her. Then in passive voice, it will become she is not liked by you. Similarly, in example 5, does he carry a bag? So in passive voice, it will become is a bag carried by him. So in the present indefinite tense or simple present tense, passive voice is formed by using am or is or are plus verb, which will be in third form, that is past participle of the verb. Similarly, negative and interrogative sentences can be formed accordingly. Present continuous tense. So here there are some examples which are in present continuous tense. So let us see how we can change the sentences from active voice to passive voice. Example 1, she is stitching a blue shirt. So here she is the subject, is stitching is the verb, which is in present continuous tense. A blue shirt is the object. So when we turn or convert it into passive voice, it will become a blue shirt is being stitched by her. Example 2, I am writing an essay. Again here the subject is I, am writing is the verb, and the object is an essay. So when we convert it to passive voice, it will become, that is the object will take the place of the subject in passive voice. It will become an essay is being written by me. Example 3, what are you doing? Which will become in passive voice, what is being done by you? Example 4, we are not listening to you. When we convert it into passive voice, it will become you are not being listened to by us. So we must remember that in the present continuous tense, passive voice is formed by using am or is or are plus being being plus the third form of the verb, which is also known as the past participle. So this is the structure that you have to follow in order to convert a sentence which is in present continuous tense to passive voice. Present perfect tense. So here are some examples and sentences which are in present perfect tense. These examples are given in both the forms, that is active voice and passive voice. So let us see how you can convert the sentences from active voice to passive voice in present perfect tense. Example 1. The farmer has tilled the field. Here, the farmer is the subject, has tilled is the verb which is in present perfect tense, and the field is the object. So in passive voice, the sentence will become, the field has been tilled by the farmer. So the object will take the place of the subject in passive voice, and the verb will become has plus been plus the third form or the past participle of the verb. So it becomes has been tilled by the farmer. Example 2. I have not bought a new car. So here I is the subject, have not bought is the verb which is in present perfect tense, and a new car is the object. So this sentence becomes, a new car has not been bought by me in passive voice. Example 3. Have you read this story? So here, in passive voice, it will change into as, has this story been read by you? Example 4. What have you done? So it will change into, what has been done by you? So we must remember that in the present perfect tense, a passive voice is formed by using has or have plus been, 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 plus the third form of the verb or the past participle. So by following the given structures, we can change the sentences from active voice to passive voice in all the present tense forms. So in our next video, we are going to discuss about active and passive voice with reference to past tense and future tense.